Not a drum was heard, not a funeral note, as his corpse to the rampart we hurried. Not a soldier discharged his farewell shot over the grave where a hero was buried. We buried him darkly at dead of night, the sods of our bayonets turning, by the struggling moonbeam's misty light and the lantern dimly burning. No useless coffin enclosed his breast, nor in sheet nor in shroud we wound him, but he lay like a warrior taking his rest with his martial cloak around him. Few and short were the prayers we said, and we spoke not a word of sorrow, but we steadfastly gazed on the face that was dead, and we bitterly thought of the morrow. We thought, as we hollowed his narrow bed and smoothed down his lonely pillow, that the foe and the stranger would tread over his head, and we far away on the billow. Lightly they'll talk of the spirit that's gone, and over his cold ashes unbreed him, but he'll give little reck if they let him sleep on in the grave where a Briton has laid him. But half of our heavy task was done when the clock struck the hour for retiring, and we heard the distant and random gun that the foe was sullenly firing. Slowly and sadly we laid him down from the field of his fame fresh and gory, and we carved not a line and we raised not a stone, but left him alone with his glory.
Here's 40 shillings on the drum for those who volunteer to come to list and fight the foe today, over the hills and far away, o'er the hills and o'er the main, through Flanders, Portugal and Spain. King George commands and we obey, over the hills and far away.